हेलो, गुड डे, सलाम, नमस्ते, मरहबा टू एवरीबडी आउट देयर। होप यू ऑल आर हैविंग अ वंडरफुल डे। कपल ऑफ डेज ब्रेक, वाज ऑब्वियसली रनिंग अराउंड विद सम अदर स्टफ टू डू विद माय डे टू डे रूटीन। सम इंफॉर्मेशन अगेन व्हिच केम अक्रॉस टू मी एंड आई थॉट इट्स प्रीटी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड आई शुड पुट इट आउट एंड शेयर इट विद ऑल ऑफ यू। I'm sure if you heard how the world trade economy is basically going nowadays, and one big major component in it is how China is factoring into everything every now and then. So, in lieu of that, essentially, in 2013, China unveiled a Silk Road plan for the 21st century, and it was a strategy that aimed or still aims to boost trade and productivity between the country, China, and across East Africa and Europe. In fact, the World Bank estimates that the strategy, which is known as the Belt and Road Initiative, or BRI, will encompass 30% of the global GDP, 62% of the world's population, and 75% of known energy reserves. So obviously, it is the next big thing to look out for. And the UAE is no further behind. It is actively involved in this particular project. In fact, the UAE had taken part in the fourth Belt and Road Initiative, which happened in Hong Kong during September 11th and 12th. The delegation was chaired by Mr. Abdullah Al Saleh, who is the Undersecretary for the Ministry of Economy. Just some quick details on what is actually happening in that particular delegation. The Economic and Trade Delegation from the UAE participated in this summit in the presence of government delegation from across 80 countries. And more than 5,000 speakers and businessmen also participated in the summit, along with government delegations. And the agenda was to discuss approximately 320 investment projects being implemented in 68 countries that are currently part of the initiative. Along with that, there are about 100 exhibitors and 520 bilateral sessions which took place. So the two-day summit in Hong Kong was basically to discuss the current status of this initiative and the role of banking, finance, technology, innovation, creativity, infrastructure, and the logistics sectors, which are in support of this particular initiative for the Belt and Road Initiative. And Mr. Saleh stated that the value of non-oil trade between the UAE and Hong Kong has risen to approximately 36 billion dirhams at the end of 2018. And that is roughly from 2017. Yes, Mr. Shan, I think you are absolutely right. It is definitely an important player in the BRI equation. Lovely input. Thank you for that. And like I was mentioning for the non-oil trade imports, this is regarding trade and commodities. Basically, the dominant imports to the UAE from Hong Kong are diamonds, which are worth approximately 4 billion dirhams, followed by gold, which is again worth about nearly 4 billion dirhams, jewelry, which is about 1.1 billion dirhams, and precious stones, which is about 450 million. Now, the UAE's non-oil export, which is again including gold, is about dirhams 1.5 billion, jewelry again, which is about 419 million, insulated wires, which is about dirhams 179 million, publications, which are worth about dirhams 18 million, diamond re-export worth about approximately 6.7 billion dirhams, and machinery and engines, which is about dirhams 993 million. Now, Mr. Saleh had pointed out that the UAE has attracted foreign investments from Hong Kong worth nearly 7.8 billion dirhams and is hosting at least 43 companies from the city, and as well as 18 commercial agencies and close to 1,600 brands. Now, the Hong Kong investments in the UAE are divided into nine categories: finance, insurance, wholesale, real trade, retail trade, motor vehicles, motorcycle repairs, manufacturing, professional, scientific, and technical activities, transport and storage, administrative and supportive services, and last but not least, construction and the real estate industry. So much so that an MOU was signed by the Shahrukh and the Hong Kong Investment Authority and the Department of Foreign Direct Investment, which is the FDI of the Hong Kong government, to expand these strategic partnerships more and to increase the scope of investments. In fact, on 26th of April this year, UAE had confirmed its role as a major player in the China's BRI mega project after announcing deals worth approximately $3.4 billion between the two countries. So all in all, I think China, UAE is extremely well positioned to be a financial, trading and servicing hub for the globalization of the Chinese economy. And UAE time and time proves the strategic importance it holds, and along with these efforts which are undergoing, the strength that the UAE economy has in servicing this particular initiative from China for the BRI. And there will be a number of major players globally who are definitely eyeing this this aspect of trade, of investment, and looking at various options to see how they can be a part of this success. So just have a think about it. I think it's a lot of numbers I threw out today, but at the same time, they are holding a lot of significance for a lot of people in different areas of different industries. And in the meantime, if you feel any time, me, IQI Dubai can hopefully try and assist you, give you a little bit more input. Just send us a message and we'll be more than happy to assist you with your queries. Have a lovely day. Thank you all. Take care.